Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. So in this video I come up with a stock idea related to a buyback announced by a major IT company, so that is Wipro Ltd. So Wipro Ltd announced a buyback in October 2020 at a price of 400 per share. So this is a lot of companies announced a buyback in this month, and including the largest IT company TCS. So I plan to produce a new video on the TCS buyback in this month itself, and I request you to watch this entire channel. In this video I will explain why this regarding the analysis of Wipro Ltd, at what valuations it is currently trading, what are the possible acceptance ratio, what are the possible entitlement ratio, and what kind of returns can we expect in Wipro in 1 year. So I request you to watch the video till the end, and subscribe to my YouTube channel so that I can actually post new videos regarding multi-bagger stock ideas and buyback investments. So I will give a brief overview of Wipro. As you know, Wipro is the third largest IT company in India in terms of revenue and employees. It actually serves clients across six continents. It actually announced a buyback in October 2020 at a price of 400 per share. It's currently trading at around 345 levels. So these are the offer details for the buyback. The buyback type is tender offer, and the buyback recorded December 11, 2020. And the offer amount is 9,500 crore. And the board meeting was done on October 13, 2020, and the announcement was made on the same day. So the buyback offer size is 4 crore. They are actually planning to buy back up to 4.16% of the paid-up capital. And the total number of shares they are proposing to buy back 20.75 crore shares. It will be a tender offer. So regarding the tender offer, what the company does is that they will actually announce they will actually set a record date, which is already announced next month as December 11, 2020. So they will actually find out who all shares held the shares of Wipro Ltd on the record date, and they will actually, based on the total number of shares that will be bought back by Wipro, they will calculate the entitlement ratio and send an email to shareholders that we are actually entitled for this much shares for the buyback offer. So maybe if the company is actually proposing to buy back 2 crore shares, and if there are 4 crore eligible shares for entitlement, they will actually propose an entitlement ratio of say 50%, and they actually send the email to shareholder that you are entitled for. Suppose the shareholders actually having 100 shares, the shareholder may be entitled for 50 shares for the buyback, and an email will be sent by Wipro to the shareholders regarding this buyback after the based on the number of shares held in the record date. And after the finalization, after the buyback opening and start date, the shareholders can apply to the buyback through their broker. And if not all the shareholders may not be opting for the buyback, because if a shareholder actually bought Wipro at the price of 100 levels or 200 levels 2 to 3 years back, they may not be sending all the shares in the buyback. So the acceptance ratio, final acceptance ratio, is likely to be higher than the entitlement ratio. So it is likely to be, if the entitlement ratio is around 30-40%, the acceptance ratio is normally higher, say around 40-50%. So based on that, the request shares will be accepted by Wipro at the price of 400, and the balance shares will be credited back into the DMAT account. That is the way the tender offer will actually work. So this particular offer by Wipro is considered attractive because it is, I will actually explain the details why we can actually term this buyback offer as attractive. So let us see the financial earnings. Let us see the earnings history of Wipro and what valuations it is currently trading. So the current market price of Wipro Ltd is around 345 levels. The market cap is 1,95,807 crores. High and low price is 382 and 159, and the stock price earning multiple is around 20.2, and the book value is 106, and dividend is 0.29%. Return on capital employed is 19.9%, and return on equity is 17.4%. Face value is 2. The sales growth for the 10 years it is 8%, for 5 years it is 5%, and 3 years 3%, and the total compounded profit growth for 10 years is 8%, 5 years it is 3%, and 3 years it is 5%. CAGR return, stock price CAGR return for 10 years is 8%, for 5 years it is 10%, and 3 years it is 16%, and the return on equity is for the 10 years it is 20%, for 5 years it is 18%, and 3 years it is 17%. So let us see the stock price movement of Wipro Ltd in the last 1 year. So last year also Wipro had announced a buyback in the price range of 325 rupees. So at that time of announcement of buyback, Wipro was trading at around 245 levels, And actually, after that, due to the COVID pandemic, it was trading at around 240 levels in February. And due to COVID pandemic, all the stock corrected and Wipro fell to around 170 levels. And it then gradually started recovering, and it actually crossed around 227 level in July 2020. And then it actually crossed 300 levels in September, and by October it was trading at around it made a high of around it crossed the buyback price of previous year's buyback price in October 2020 and made a high of around 377. So it announced this buyback of the level of 400 levels in October 2020. After that, the stock had a correction, is now trading at around 340 levels. So it is not considered in the original price at 377 levels. There was not much return for investors in buyback. So considering the current price around 340 levels, considering that it is trading at 17 times, it is not very expensive at the current levels, and some returns are expected on the buyback also, and good returns are possible in the long term also. Let's see the earnings history of the Wipro Limited. So if you see the last 2 year return of Wipro Limited, so it had a sales of around 13,669 crores in December 2017, and it gradually improved over the years. It was around 14,568 in September 2020. It was around 15,131 in September 2029, and last year it was quarter it was around 14,923. The sales was impacted last quarter due to COVID pandemics, and the clients across the world had really reduced their IT spending, and it has actually improved this quarter, and it was around 15,097 crores. So you can see that the sales or the total income has increased around 1,600 crores in the last 2 years. Regarding the operating profit, it was just 2,487 crores in December 2017. It gradually increased to around 3,293 crores in December 2018. It was around 3,437 crores this quarter. So I mean the operating profit has increased around 1,000 crores in the last 2 years. Regarding the profit after tax, it was around 1,931 crores in December 2017. It has actually improved to around 2,510 crores in December 2018. It was around 2,466 crores in the last quarter. So it is actually net profit has also increased to around 500 crores in the last two years. The EPS also improved from around 3.20 in December 2017 to around 4.31 in this current quarter. So if you see the full year, we are actually expecting EPS of around 18 to 20 rupees for Wipro Limited. So considering the buyback at 400 is just around 20-22 times FY21 expected EPS, which is not very expensive. Considering the valuations of other peer companies like TCS and Infos, which are trading at around 26 to 30 times. So if you see the long-term earnings of the Wipro, it was sales was around 25,700 crores in March 2009. It gradually improved, obviously. It was around 37,430 in 2013. It improved again to around 51,244 in March 2016. And the current last year, it was around 61,138 crores. It's likely to be around 61,240 crores in this year. So operating profit has improved from around 4,882 crores in 2009 to around 9,635 crores in 2014, and to further to around 12,925 crores and expected to be around 12,925 crores in FY21. So I mean that almost it has almost increased three times from the period in 2009. The profit after tax also improved from around 3,900 crores to around 6,150 crores in 2013. Further to around 8,908 crores in 2016 to further to around 9,638 crores in this year. It's expected to be around 9,638 crores this year. So the EPS has also improved from around 6 levels in 2009 to around 13 levels in 2015, further to around 15 levels in 2019. Last year it was around 17, it's likely to be around 18 to 20 levels in FY21. It has announced two bonus issues. It was actually bonus issue was announced in 2010 in the ratio 1:1. It announced further bonus in 2017 in the ratio 1:2 and 1:1. Sorry, and it actually announced a buyback in 2019. So the equity capital dropped to around 50 crores. So this is actually likely to reduce further after the current buyback. Promoters hold around 74% in Wipro, and the FIs holding is around 8.39% in public domestic institution mutual fund holding is around 6.49%. So if you see the expectation for Wipro in future, considering the growth in EPS and profit over the years, for FY21 we are actually expecting EPS around 18 to 20. So the buyback at 400 levels is done at around 2020 to FY21 EPS, which is not very expensive. And the last year buyback was done at 325 ratio, had an acceptance ratio of 53%. So the current buyback is also likely to get an acceptance ratio in the range of 30 to 60%. So it is the third largest IT company in India with 1.3 lakh employees. It has a history of rewarding shareholders in terms of bonus issues and buyback, etc. Investment of around 10,000 rupees made in Wipro 20-30 years back is now worth over 10-20 crores, more than 20 crores. So even if there is any correction after buyback, the share price is expected to cross the 400 levels in the next 6 months to 1 year. And it's possible that due to the huge profitability that of the Wipro, they may announce a buyback in the future also at the price of around 500 levels. So even if you are actually holding the shares, balance share that is not accepting buyback, you are actually expected to gain a good return in Wipro in future also. So let us see what are the possible expectations on this buyback and how, based on the possible acceptance ratio. So the total buyback is around 9,500 crores and the price is 400 rupees. So and the total quantity that we bought back is 23.75 crore shares and the retail buyback is 15% of that amount, that is 3.56 crore shares. So if you see the annual report of the company, you can see that the shareholding, based on the shareholding pattern 2020, the total shareholders who actually held shares till 5,000 shares of 8.23 crores. So that can increase because many shareholders may have bought shares of Wipro in the after the announcement of buyback. So the entitlement ratio can actually reduce. So based on that particular calculation, based on annual report, the entitlement ratio is 3.56 by 8.2 crores. That comes to around 43%. It may not be accurate. You are actually referred to some other websites or YouTube channels and get the correct entitlement ratio. Based on my calculation, based on annual report of March 2020, the entitlement ratio has to be 43%. But there can be new shareholders may have bought shares and the entitlement ratio is likely to reduce around 30%. But it is likely to be in the range of 30 to 40% range entitlement ratio. So if you are actually expecting an acceptance ratio of 40%, because then acceptance ratio is likely to be higher than entitlement ratio, because normally the long term shareholder who bought Wipro at 100 levels or 200 levels may not be tendering the shares in the buyback. They may be tendering only, say they are actually holding 500 shares, they may be tendering only 200 shares or 300 shares. So the entitlement acceptance ratio is likely to be higher than the entitlement ratio. So if you are actually expecting 40% as acceptance ratio, at the current market price of 345, we are actually purchasing 200 shares. The total cost is 69,000. Considering the acceptance of 40%, 80 shares will be accepted in the buyback. And the balance 120 shares, if we are actually selling at 345 levels, our total value would be 32,000 plus 41,000. We are actually gaining around 4,400 rupees. Suppose if 40% is accepted and the balance shares we are actually selling at 370 rupees, the total gain would be around 7,400 rupees. And suppose we are actually holding for around 6 months to 1 year and the price becomes 400, and if you are selling the all the shares, balance share that is not accepted buyback at 400 levels, the total gain would be 11,000 rupees. So considering the acceptance ratio 50%, if you are actually 50% means that 100 shares would be accepted at 400 levels. So the balance shares, if you are actually selling at the current price of 345, our total gain would be 5,500. So if you are actually selling the balance unaccepted shares at 370 levels, our total gain would be 8,000 rupees. If you are selling only the all shares only at 400 levels in the next 6 months or 1 year, our gain would be 11,000 rupees. So there is a good possibility that we can actually, if you are actually holding the shares of Wipro for long term, we can actually expect to get good returns. And we can actually possibly expect another buyback from Wipro in the next 1 to 2 years at around 500 levels. So I feel that the Wipro is a very good stock for long-term investment. So a risk-averse investor can keep a stop loss, but I feel that there is good returns are possible in Wipro. So if you like my video, please subscribe to my channel. Before exiting from my video, please refer to the disclaimer also.